Hare Krishna.
Even if our worldview stays out of view, it shapes our every view. We view many things in our life and we mold our actions accordingly. Based on what we think is desirable, we seek that, and what is undesirable, we avoid that. However, our view of what is desirable and what is undesirable is shaped by our worldview. Our worldview shapes our every view. Worldview means what we think ultimately matters in life, what life is meant for, what is it that will give us happiness in life. And most of us, we don't think about our worldview. For in our consciousness, our worldview stays out of view. The worldview of most people in today's world is materialistic. And a materialistic worldview means that we are indoctrinated into believing that matter is all that matters, or maybe even matter is all that exists, that material pleasures are life's be-all and end-all. And this view shapes, this worldview shapes our every view. So if anyone talks about anything higher in life, we are just not interested, because we feel this doesn't make any sense to me, this doesn't matter to me. What is the pleasure in this? We don't even explore whether there's anything, any pleasure in spirituality, because we feel that's not for me. So it's even without thinking or leave alone evaluating, we just reject things that don't fit into our worldview. And Krishna talks about the pervasive corrupting effects of a materialistic worldview when he says in 16.8, asatyam pratishtham te jagadahuranishwaram aparaspara sambhutam kimanyat kamahaitukam asatyam apratishtham te. That those who are materialistic people, they say there is no ultimate truth, there is no sustaining foundation for the world, there is no God in control. And then, what is the purpose of life? Kimanyat kamahaitukam. Apart from sensual indulgence, what could be the purpose of life? Kimanyat kamahaitukam. So, when this becomes people's driving conception of life, then even if they do religious activities, they do those for materialistic pleasure only. As Krishna talks about the ungodly later, in the same chapter in 16.15, he says that yakshe dasyami modishya ityagyana vimohitah, that even if they give charity and perform yagya, they do it to show ishvaroham aham bhogi siddho aham balwan sukhi adhyo bijanvan asmi konyosti sadrusho maya. Who is there like me, who is pious, virtuous, charitable like me? So their charity is not to increase their spirituality or their purity, it is simply to increase their popularity. And even if they do yagya, ajante nama yagyaiste dambhena vidipurvakam, 2:8 and 16.17, Krishna says that such people perform yagya simply for the sake of gaining name and fame. So therefore, such people are shaped, all their actions, their every view, even their view of religion, which is meant to be a pathway to spirituality, even their view of religion is shaped by their materialistic worldview. So by understanding how pervasive the effect of our worldview is, when we study the Bhagavad Gita, it's not just about changing our view, it's about challenging our worldview. So the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna came with a materialistic but pious worldview, a worldview of pious materialism. And the Bhagavad Gita elevates him to a spiritual worldview. So by at least understanding that how our worldview shapes our every view, we can start bringing our worldview in view and examine it properly. And then thereby we can choose the worldview that gives us the best view of reality, that harmonizes best with reality, and that best takes us towards the ultimate reality. Such is the worldview provided by the Bhagavad Gita. Thank you. Hare Krishna.